16th shadow, indifference, the diffusion of responsibility. At the shadow frequency, one of the most powerful and pervasive forces that keeps you from perceiving a higher reality is indifference. As long as you are indifferent, you can't ever be different. This is the key to the 16th shadow, which concerns the very human fear of leaving your comfort zone and fully embracing change in your life. As an aspect of the codon ring of prosperity, the 16th gene key is about excellence. To prosper truly in the world is to find the one thing in life at which you excel above all others. This is the true destiny of every human being, but to bring this dream to fruition, you must first step out of the shadows and take the risk of being different. Indifference is an energy field that gets you to focus your precious time and life force on the inessential. The inessential in this context is anything that takes your attention away from the present moment and its limitless potential. As long as you are focused on the inessential, you will be indifferent to the things in life that really. The gene key represents the collective expression of the state of health of humanity. In our modern world, this expression is clear, that the vast majority of the world lives in poverty, whilst a select few thrive, is a testament to the power of the 16th shadow, which sucks all the life out of the world. Because human beings are not willing to stand up and be different, they become willing to sit by the side of life and observe. In social psychology, this common human pattern is known as the diffusion of responsibility and refers to the human preponderance to look away when confronted by another in distress, often when there are a number of other people in the same vicinity. However, as a byproduct of the 16th shadow of indifference, the diffusion of responsibility occurs across the width and breadth of our planet on a far subtler energetic level. Indifference is an energy field created by all the human beings on this planet who are not doing what they would really love to be doing. The only reason for this state is fear. Whoever you are and whatever your life circumstances, if you transcend your fear, you will suddenly become so much more capable than you were before. To break out of the field of indifference is to make the courageous move deep into your own fears and overcome the lethargy that prevents you from making something truly beautiful of your life. Indifference has many faces and excuses. One of the primary excuses is enough time. This habit of making yourself a victim of time is the core escape strategy of the 16th shadow, but time actually has nothing to do with it. You have become a victim of your mind rather than of time. Time itself is as fluid as water, and as the 17th and 5th and 52nd gene keys testify, it can be bent, shortened, twisted, lengthened, and even stopped. The moment you take a stand and begin to follow your dreams, time becomes your ally rather than your enemy, automatically adapting itself to fit your needs. The programming partner to the 16th shadow is the 9th shadow of inertia, and it is easy to see how these two genetic forces keep humans from actually getting anywhere. As with all the shadow polarities, they create a biofeedback loop that traps energy at a low frequency. In this case, indifference cannot overcome inertia because it doesn't feel strongly enough to do anything about it. This 16th shadow can be absolutely full of plans and good intentions about the world, but they rarely get off the ground. This is the shadow of the pipe dream, the delusion that your dreams will one day become manifest without you ever actually having to initiate them. What is lacking in the lives of those in the grip of this shadow is one vital factor: enthusiasm. Enthusiasm is the original Chinese name for this 16th hexagram of the I Ching. Enthusiasm is the key that can pull you out of your inertia and snap the frozen pattern of your indifference. To be enthused, you must actually have an experience rather than simply dreaming about an experience. One of the greatest challenges in surmounting the collective weight of indifference is your unique inability to identify with whatever your dreams really are. This is why experience is critical to this process of breaking free. It is not enough to daydream and plan how you might save the world. You have to actually begin the work. The other major excuse of those under the spell of this shadow is, "I am not ready yet." Again, this excuse is based on a false notion of time. The truth is that you are always ready. You are ready right now. If you keep postponing your dreams, they will always remain dreams. If you actually have the courage to begin them, you will learn as you go along. When you have the courage to step onto the path of your destiny, two things immediately occur. The first is that you feel an enormous surge of new energy coming from your own enthusiasm, and the second is that you stop compromising your path because of pressure coming from others. Only your courage and your enthusiasm have the power to break through the collective energetic walls created by the diffusion of responsibility. Down at the shadow frequencies, you have no idea what is possible. You see only with your mind, which is incapable of encompassing full reality. Your enthusiasm has the power to overcome the mass propaganda, telling you that your dreams are impossible, and your courage is a sword protecting you from individual pressure that threatens to choke you. With this newfound courage, you can finally stand as a fully embodied human presence. There is a deep entrepreneurial spirit here in this genetic codon. It is, after all, called the Ring of Prosperity. It is the fusion of human talent coupled with the power of group synergy, the 45th gene key, that opens the field for true prosperity. The more you expand into your talent, the more the universal field of consciousness responds, coming to meet you halfway. Only by striking out alone will you find the right people to support, orient, and bring your vision to fruition. The 16th shadow has much to do with the unique gifts concealed within every human being, but at the shadow frequency, this can be very confusing. The 16th shadow puts all its emphasis on skills, techniques, and systems, rather than on the human spirit that enlivens them. These people can become addicted to information and techniques, but rarely transcend these techniques. The 16th shadow creates experts, whereas the 16th city creates masters. The distance between the two is almost unfathomable. To be an expert is to remain indifferent and unenthused, because once enthusiasm has been unleashed, skill gives way to something far more magical. It opens up the amazing gift of versatility. As you become more versatile, you, for the first time, become truly different. You become special. And the moment that happens, you have finally killed indifference. Repressive nature. Gullible. When indifference is repressed, it manifests as gullibility. These people become victims of the mass propaganda of the collective. An example here is people who use the excuse that if governments cannot help the world situation, how can they? This gullibility essentially allows people to hide their indifference behind the indifference of others. At the deepest level, this gullibility fosters individual weakness and a feeling of powerlessness. Every time you turn on the news on television, for example, you meet this huge negative conditioning field. How you respond to this field determines your frequency. The response of the repressive nature is to bury your head in the sand in the belief that nothing can be done. Reactive nature, self-deluded. The nature of indifference actually makes it impossible for a person to react, so the reactive nature in this instance appears to be something of a misnomer. These people hide their fear in their obsession with structure, systems, and techniques. They become so deeply identified with the structures their minds are following that they forget about the reason for the structure in the first place. This gives rise to a deep self-delusion, in which these people build powerful mental walls around themselves, keeping the world and others locked out. In a certain sense, these people are also gullible, like the repressive nature, but their gullibility concerns their own propaganda rather than anyone else's. They are convinced by their own minds. However, behind their mental walls seethes a huge anger that is far from indifferent and which will eventually destroy them unless they can see through their own self-delusion. The 16th to create magic on earth. The power of love is here now.
The 16th gene key. The transformational path of the 16th gene key moves from indifference to mastery, and it's the path of versatility. It's really amazing when you look at all the gene keys as a whole, because you see all these qualities and frequencies. And you also see how certain shadow frequencies really underpin so much of our collective behavior patterns. The 16th gene key is really interesting. It's one of those gene keys that has an exponential effect on the world, especially at the shadow frequency. It's the shadow of indifference. And it's what the world is like when love is excluded. And recently I was listening to all these great writers and thinkers talking about what it means to be human. And the question was, what makes us human? And there were some really interesting responses. I thought about it, and my response would be this. To be human is to have the ability, even the tendency, to overcome indifference. Indifference makes us inhuman. And humanity is all about caring. Caring for each other, for the world, caring about what happens in the future, caring about what's happening now. This is uniquely human. But the shadow frequency drops us below this definition. So not to care is really to be dead. If you don't care, you might as well be dead. I know that sounds harsh, but until you can feel the love that you were born with, you're really not here. So take a look at the world. So many people are just not really here. They're just bodies going through the motions, automatons. It's like one of those zombie movies, the shadow frequency. And you know why we are indifferent? We're indifferent because we're lazy. That's the dilemma of the 16th shadow. Laziness is the dilemma of the 16th gene key. We're too lazy to care. We can't be bothered. We're trapped by our indifference. We don't know how to get out of it. And when I speak of laziness here, I mean it at a very deep level. We're too lazy to even take a look inside our hearts. We get into our comfort zone with our emails and our jobs and our safe little worlds, and we just get lazy. Awakening takes discipline. Anything worthwhile takes discipline. So to unlock your genius, you're going to have to work hard, at least at an internal level. You really have to look into your own heart, and very few people are actually willing to look into their own heart, the layers of pain that are in there. Do you know what happens when you do? A breakthrough. Always a breakthrough happens. So this 16th shadow governs huge swathes of the human race because there's safety in numbers. If no one else is really bothering, why should I? I'll just tag along and do my own thing. But the world is really screwed up in certain areas. Like money, for example. The 16th gene key is part of the ring of prosperity, and that's a codon group that designs behavior across whole gene pools. So in the name of money, we can be as indifferent as we like. And this is the norm in our society. You can do anything and get away with it if you have a lot of money. Look at corporate greed, for example. Where does the buck stop? They're actually polluting our planet, but we don't know who they are. And when you actually find these people, they're usually quite normal people with families and the same issues as the rest of us, but they don't question their behavior because no one else does. We're all indifferent together. We're in it together. We're all too goddamn lazy to wake up. Because to wake up, you'll have to push against the flow, big time. At least that's how you might imagine it. But the thing is, waking up isn't draining. It's exactly the opposite. It gives you vast energy. It makes you feel alive. To open your heart and live from your heart makes you stand out on our planet. The 16th shadow is all about wasted talent. If you have the shadow in your profile, then you may recognize this theme. You have so much potential, but no discipline. So you waste your gifts. You ignore your genius. Your fear makes you lazy. But that's all it is. It's just fear. You're afraid. Be honest. Afraid that if you open your heart up to life and all its suffering, then you'll drown. You'll be overwhelmed. But you won't be, because the heart cannot be overwhelmed. It just opens more to encompass the change. So if you have this gene key, then it's time to wake up. No one is ever going to come and help you. This is something you have to do yourself, alone. But I tell you, when you overcome your laziness, then your life will never be the same again. You will be flooded with purpose. Your relationships will soar. Your life will move onto a whole new plane of being. You really should do it. The 16th gift, versatility. This is such a great gift. You won't believe what lies hidden behind laziness and indifference. By the way, I just want to be clear one more time about this laziness, because there is a laziness that's powerful, but that's a different quality entirely. The powerful version of laziness is about effortlessness. It's about ease or relaxedness. It's a quality associated with flow. But that doesn't come from indifference. Indifference is more about sloth, about being stuck, and it takes something really powerful to get you out of such a state. Ironically though, this same quality of ease runs all the way through this gene key. So the gift of versatility emerges in your life as a kind of effortlessness. To be versatile means to be multifaceted. It means you can easily transfer your talent across a number of fields. Once you crack through the resistance and your heart begins to warm, then you find self-discipline easy. It's not really possible to get to the highest frequencies without huge inner discipline. But the nature of this discipline changes as the frequency rises. It becomes easier. So you have to begin with passion and with focus, and then you'll find that you have the energy necessary to follow things through. The 16th gene key opens humanity up to so many creative possibilities. It's the domain of the polymath. I love this term, polymath. It's fallen kind of out of vogue these days, which I think shows our level of indifference. A polymath is someone whose wisdom spans many different fields of knowledge and endeavor. The term was coined during the Renaissance, when certain spirited individuals and geniuses dedicated themselves to higher knowledge and understanding over a wide range of fields. That could be anything from physical excellence to intellectual understanding. Through the power of this 16th gift, I can really see a new rising up of the polymath in our society again. Because the problem with the modern approach is its specialization. People at university, for example, they become so specialized in their approach that they become kind of myopic. But if we had an education system that was set up differently, you might even begin with specialization, and then as you see into the holographic truth of a single subject, you could see from that how the same higher theme or the same strain runs through all subjects. So you would become less specialized as you advanced. The 16th gift learns holographically, using heart, body and mind all synthesized. This is a gene key about excellence. And once indifference is taken out of the equation, all that skill and all that natural talent can be used to serve the whole rather than to serve individual fame and fortune. You can only truly prosper when you're helping others and when you're helping them with integrity. Remember, this is the ring of prosperity. And so many people in the world think they're helping the whole, but because they don't see the big picture, because they're not listening to the whole, they don't realize that they're not really helping at all. To serve life is to respect every level of society. It's to revere the chain of life. It's to understand the interconnectedness of all things. This is where the gift of versatility comes from this holographic wisdom. And this gene key isn't all about being intellectual, though it probably will have a very keen intellect. It's about an expansion of intelligence, of IQ, EQ, and SQ. If you follow my Golden Path program, you'll know exactly what all those terms mean. Higher intelligence is a fusion of heart, mind, and spirit. So we need a new type of thinker in the world, one who isn't sunk into their mind alone, one whose spirit isn't for sale to the highest bidder, one whose emotional life has matured enough so they can use their feminine qualities in harmony with the masculine. And there aren't many of them yet. But the time of the polymath is coming. And one day I envisage them leading us in business, in education, in science, in all subjects. They found the versatility of the higher faculties latent in the human heart. And they're dedicated to serving the vision that flows from that heart. Bring it on, I say. The 16th city, mastery. So what is mastery? What is a master? This is the question that this 16th city invites. Is a master some white-bearded Indian yogi with flowers around his neck? Or is a master something less definable? Most people who have tried to answer this question have been men. Even the word master seems to be a male word. So I think it's well overdue for an overhaul in understanding. So let's start again with a completely fresh slate on this one. We know that a master is the opposite end of the spectrum to indifference. So the master must be extremely sensitive, but not in a weak way. This is sensitivity as strength. So a master feels everything. And this already sounds a lot more feminine. The master is a receiver, an open book. And the master must also be a paradox. The master combines the focus of the yang with the receptivity of the yin. The leap from the gift to the city is not really so very far. Versatility requires viscosity, flexibility, and openness. So what happens after the heart has opened? The gift describes the process of the actual opening of your heart. It opens, it closes, you open it again, it closes again. It's a stretching, a process, a learning. You're carving yourself into being. And at a certain point, you've just learned the trick. Your heart softens to such an extent that it's no longer necessary to close off. You've mastered the art. And the art is life. So to be a master means to be a master of living. This isn't about skill or talent anymore. It's reached the essential. The greatest art of all is to live well. And we're never taught this. No one even mentions it when you're young. The art of living well. That would be a great open university course. Actually, it's exactly what the Gene Key's golden path is. Purpose, partnership, prosperity. The art of living well, the three P's. When these three have been integrated and have become a seamless symphony in your life, then you can be said to be a master. You see, that's very different from the old image of mastery. Perhaps you thought it needed hours of meditation every day. Perhaps you thought it was the domain of the ascetic. But I tell you, it isn't. It's for the ordinary human being. Mastery is for everyone. It isn't exclusive or elite. You needn't go to India in the winter for long, silent retreats. It doesn't require specialization. The one place you can discover mastery is in your everyday life. It's the only place. And there are people who already exhibit this city, and I'm sure you know one. They glide through life. They give of themselves, but not out of avoidance of some deep issue. They just give because they wish to, and they're cheerful. And again, it's not a feigned cheerfulness. It's a bubbling up of life. They're the least indifferent people you'll find. Think of such a person. I bet you anything they're ordinary. I bet you they pass almost unnoticed in the world. I'm sure they're appreciated and loved, but I bet others don't see them as a master. And I'm sure they themselves don't see themselves like that. But such people are scattered throughout the world in every community. They aren't perfect, but they've somehow mastered the art of living. They may not be rich, but you can tell they're prospering. They may not have a rose-tinted, tantric, love and light relationship, but you can tell they're devoted to someone. And they may not be living a great big public life where they're recognized, but you can tell they've found something inside. They've found their higher purpose, and they emanate it as a jewel-like frequency. They live well. Such people are precious because they remind us of why we're here. We're here to learn how to live well. That is what mastery is. You see, it doesn't seem so very hard. But I assure you, it does take inner discipline. And that discipline is something you have to find when you're ready. And if you don't think you're ready, then you're simply making excuses because you're born ready. So there's this wonderful softness to this 16th city. You can see why it's allied to the ninth city of invincibility. Because only the ordinary person is invincible. And the master is a master of ordinariness. This is why they become extraordinary. Don't you love how words work? Versatility doesn't get as much attention as specialization. Specialization makes you seem special. You become an expert in something, and everyone wants your opinion. You become powerful in the world. But that's not inner power. That's not real prosperity. Real prosperity is found in the detail. It's found in the little things. The flower in the pavement, the smile of a child, and giving someone your last mouthful of dessert. All those little things add up to mastery. But in and of themselves, they don't seem so much. But when they all come together, you have mastery. And mastery is about time. It's about what you spend your awareness on. That's what prosperity is. It's about how you invest your time. If you invest it in the inessential, then the energy flows away from you. I learned so much from my little daughter. You know, sometimes in the mornings I wake up early to write. And I love that time before the children are even awake. But often she senses I'm awake and appears and climbs into bed with me. And she makes me close my laptop. And you know, I've learned to close my laptop when she appears now. Because those are the most precious times of my life. And they'll be gone in just a few years as she grows up. That sweetness between father and young daughter. No power in this world should come between that. And you look at your life and you find those examples when life calls you to your mastery. It calls you out of your indifference, out of your busyness, out of your laziness. That's richness. That's wealth. That's the only thing worth living for.